I am home. I give you comfort. I shelter your family. See me for who I am. Home, sweet home. I am your refuge. I am the floor that supports you, the foundation that keeps you steady, the walls that give you shelter, the roof that protects you. I am your home. If you do not take care of me, I cannot take care of you. Because I don't really need people, but people need me. Yes, your future depends on me. My oceans, my soil, my flowing streams, my forests, they all can take you or leave you. How you choose to live each day, whether you regard or disregard me, that doesn't really matter to me. Your actions will determine your fate, not mine. I am nature. I will go on. I am prepared to evolve.
Hello friends, my name is Toshini Mukherjee. Do you know Environment Day is celebrated every year on 5th June to raise awareness about environment protection? Let's sing a song on Environment Day. Let's perform together. Environment Day, Environment Day. Should make our message clear. Love and clean our earth each day. Make that a plan, a plan to stay. Make that a plan, a plan to stay. Reduce, reuse and recycle. Reduce, reuse and recycle. Make every day.
Hariom, today is World Environment Day. It is celebrated annually on 5th June and is the United Nations principal vehicle for encouraging awareness and action for the protection of the environment. It was established in 1972 by the United Nations at the Stockholm Conference, first held in 1974. It has been a platform for rising awareness on environmental issues such as marine pollution, global warming, sustainable consumption, wildlife crime, air pollution, plastic pollution, sea level increase, etc. etc. The theme for World Environment Day 2021, that is this year, ecosystem restoration. It can take many forms like growing trees, rebuilding gardens, cleaning up rivers and coast, and a lot other actions. In our country, we treated the nature like our mother. The Vedas, Puranas, Upanishad, Ramayana, Mahabharata and other earliest extract of the religion extensively exhibits holistic cosmic vision with strong environmental ethics and consistent emphasis on preservation of ecological balance. In our country, people show deep respect for all the elements of earth. The basic premise of every religion is that man coexists with other forms of beings in a system where everything is interdependent and flow of energy is cyclic. The Prithivi Sukta in Atharva Veda states, Mata Bhumihi Putroham Prithivyah means my mother is earth and I am her son. Our forefathers and previous civilization used to respect and worship nature because nature is abundant. It is the provider. It has everything which any living being needs to survive, and they used to thank Mother Nature for all generosity and taking care of all the living beings. Our Earth is the only planet in the universe till date which has an environment suitable for life. But have we followed the footsteps of our previous civilizations? Let's have a look at the biggest environmental problems existing on Earth today. Pollution has become one of the most concerning issues for our planet and mankind. This has disturbed the balance of ecosystem. It impacts our lifestyle severely. As the world is getting more modern, pollution is also enhancing day by day. It's like we are the prisoners of our own creations. Due to this, there is an imbalance in nature. So many birds, animals and plants are on the verge of extinction day by day. Every day we keep on harming the environment using non-biodegradable products, no limit on industrial waste, no proper waste disposal, destroying our rivers, air, harassing the animals. In short, we have destroyed our own biodiversity. Let's have a look at a social experiment which aims to increase our awareness, and it also shows how selfish have human become.
Hi, come on in, have a seat. So good morning everyone. When's the last time any of you drew a picture?
Past five.
Today we're here to draw a picture. So what you'll see here are some crayons, colors in each box. Choose your colors wisely because there will be another group coming in after you and making another picture with what you leave behind. Here we have the other group.
Everybody say hi.
Why don't we show the kids the pictures that we've drawn?
Yeah. Oh. Sure.
So nice.
Wow. Yeah.
Why don't you show them what you drew?
It's all black.
We all took away the bright colors.
I wish I wasn't this selfish, taking away all the bright colors.
Maybe we could have broken the colors and left half of them for them and for the next crew.
Have you even thought about your future self? About your future generation? Even now, everyone is facing consequences of humans' actions. Cities are facing problem of water shortage. There is water war among states. In many foreign countries, people have to buy clean drinking water. So what are we trying to achieve? A world full of hatred with all national resources depleted? With great power comes great responsibility. Be responsible. Don't overutilize resources. Use whatever is required. Not all is lost. Still there is hope. Many countries are passing laws which are nature friendly. And people at their personal level are also striving to save Earth. Many countries and cities have banned plastic. In India, Kannur is a place where plastic is totally banned. Many places around the world have been declared as eco-sensitive zone and hence human activities are prohibited there. Many national parks, wildlife sanctuary and biosphere reserves are there to protect wildlife, give them a safe environment and limit human activities. Children, now you think, what is your contribution in this noble act of saving the environment? Make a diary and write every day which way you have protected your environment. Every small thing counts. Children, the beauty of nature lies in the diversity. Don't let it be destroyed. Hari Om.
And good morning to each and everyone present over here. I am Mayank Pandey and I am here to tell you about some of the beneficial plants which will help us fight this pandemic all the way. There are many air purifiers in the market, but according to the well-known doctor, it is said that they all have no use as they are not efficient. So there are many beneficial plants which will help us purify the air and thus help us keeping our lungs healthy. The first plant which I am going to tell you about is the Areca palm plant. It helps in purifying air by removing carbon monoxide and formaldehyde present in air and thus purifying it. Two or three plants of around 6 feet, 3 feet should be planted in the house so that the air all around could be purified and all the virus and bacteria present in air could be killed. The next plant which I am going to talk about is the mother-in-law tongue plant. The special feature of the plant is it converts carbon dioxide into oxygen during night also. Around 6 feet of this type should be planted in the house in order to keep a pure and healthy atmosphere to live in. The other name of this plant is snake plant and the bedroom plant. Third plant which I am going to talk about is the most common plant which we all know about. It is the money plant. Money plant help us in providing pure air and sufficient amount of oxygen to breathe in. By planting all these three plants, we can purify the atmosphere all around us. And if this will be followed by each and every citizen of the country, then it would also help in lowering down the pollution index of the whole country, and it would help us to have good and healthy lungs. With this, I conclude. Thank you and have a nice day.
Considered as one of the most remarkable days for encouraging awareness and action for the protection of the environment, the World Environment Day is celebrated every year on the 6th of June across the globe. It provides a global platform for public outreach in which more than 143 countries participate. Each year, it provides a theme and a forum for communities, NGOs, governments, and celebrities to advocate their environmental causes. It was on the first day of the Stockholm Conference on Human Environment, 1972, that the United Nations General Assembly decided to establish World Environment Day. This World Environment Day was celebrated for the first time in 1974 with the theme of Only One Planet. This year, the World Environment Day activities will be hosted by Pakistan with the theme of ecological restoration. Ecological restoration refers to assisting the recovery of the ecological systems which have been degraded by deforestation, pollution, and other human activities. It will also be accompanied by a 10-year-long campaign launched by the United Nations Environment Programme with the theme of Recreate, Reimagine, and Restore, which focuses on reversing the decline of our natural resources. One of the biggest menaces to the human race on this planet today is the rising level of environmental pollution. We humans have been using these precious natural resources wastefully for many years, and as a result, the quality of the air which we breathe is deteriorating, the water which we consume is being contaminated, the soils in which our crops grow is being polluted, climate change and global warming is being witnessed on a very large scale, and the biodiversity of our earth is being threatened. Still, many people are ignorant to it and will waste paper and litter around in public places, which is indicative how they are not caring about their environment and about their nature. Sadly, many of us are like this, and that is why this day is important, to act as an eye-opener for those citizens who still cannot understand the gravity of this situation. The ongoing pandemic has made us understand how much of a harm we have done to our environment and how essential it is to act immediately for the betterment of our surroundings and for the betterment of our future generations. Therefore, we must realize that we have to act now, otherwise our future generations will be deprived of their basic necessities. A wise man had once said that the greatest threat to our planet is the belief that someone else will save it. And that is why we must realize that every little act, every little deed of ours matters when it comes to saving the environment. No matter how small a step you take towards leading a greener lifestyle, it does make a difference. Because if each one of us starts taking these little steps towards leading a greener lifestyle, then we will achieve a tremendous impact on our environment. That is why it is also very important to educate people around us about the environment and encourage them to take part in occasions such as this. Thank you.
Let us join our hands together to make this world beautiful.